Hi friends, today we'll be making shakkarpara. It's a Diwali special snack and it is Indian cookies. Kids will love this. Ingredients will be 1.5 cup of wheat flour, 1/4 cup of milk, 1/4 cup of sugar, and 2 tablespoons of ghee. So we'll be adding ghee in a pan. For heating, you can either dissolve milk and sugar together, like to till the sugar is dissolved and mix it well, or mix everything together and heat it till the sugar is dissolved. Either of the way is good. Like you can take the warm milk, dissolve sugar in it, and then add it into the ghee. Or you, how I'm doing, you can mix all together and heat it till the sugar is dissolved. And switch on the gas and stir it occasionally till the sugar is dissolved. You can see now the sugar has been dissolved completely. Now I'll switch off the gas and meanwhile we'll start kneading the dough. We'll sieve the flour. 1.5 cup of wheat flour. 'll be adding a pinch of salt. I'll be adding sendha namak, which will not have any contradiction if used with milk. After sieving, now we'll add the mixture of ghee, sugar and milk, which was warm. So I'll be mixing it with a spoon. For the beginners, you need to add little by little and then knead it. I was confident enough, so I started kneading it directly. And you can use the spoon, and once it is cooled down, you can use the fingers. Now I will knead into smooth dough with hand. The precaution you have to take is you just don't need to add water or anything. Keep on kneading it till it is smooth. If at all it is very stiff, then you can add warm water, just sprinkling the warm water and then kneading it. And if it is very loose, then you can just cover it and rest for 30 minutes to 1 hour. I'll divide the dough into 4 parts and then we'll make paras from it. So I have divided into 4 parts and we'll roll it like chapati, but the thick chapati. Now we can fry the paras or can make the other sections, and then all together you can fry, anything you can do. After rolling the chapati, we can cut into cubes like a square shape or the diamond shape, any shape if you want, and you don't need to bother about the side edges which is cracked. Now we'll make paras from other dough, other 3 portions. Try to cut this into diamond shape now. We'll show you diamond shape. Now we'll keep the oil for frying. And for this shakkarpara, you need slow to medium flame only. You will never go for the fast flame. Meanwhile, we'll finish kneading the last portion of our dough. We'll put small portion of our dough and we'll check the oil is ready. If it is coming slowly up, then the oil is ready for frying. Now our oil is ready, so we'll put in shakkarpara one by one and we'll fry it in the slow flame only. We don't need to stir it continuously. Occasionally you can just stir it and flip it over till golden brown color. When you'll fry for the first time, you'll find it is soft even if it is turned golden brown. But once it is cooled down, it will be crispier from outside and the inside will be like cookies or biscuit or naan khatai, and it will be crunchy from outside. Likewise, we'll fry all our patches. So you can hear the crunch of paadas, you can see the fluffiness. So our yummy delicious Indian cookies shakkar paada is ready. Our Diwali snack shakkar paada is ready. You can store it in an airtight container. So our yummy Indian cookies your kids will love, and it is healthier option than other biscuits. Do try this on this Diwali. Happy Diwali to all my viewers. Please like, share and subscribe my channel.